Welcome back inside Frost Arena. It's semifinal Friday here in the girls' AA state tournament. The Jackrabbits hosting the state tournament here in South Dakota State University inside Frost Arena. Tonight we've got the Washington Warriors and the Brandon Valley Lynx as they get set to face off. The winner of this game, of course, will take on the winner of our last game just a few moments ago. It'll be Mitchell, the top seed. So a lot on the line here tonight between these two teams as the Warriors retake the court. And let's start with our starting lineup tonight for the Sioux Falls Washington Warriors. Nate Melchow, the head coach for this Washington Warriors team, trying to get back to the state championship. And they're going to be led by their senior guard, Sarah Zirpel, the 5'7 senior. Joining her on the floor will be Ellie Benson, the 5'8 sophomore, Jessica Carson, Emma Hansen, and Hannah Weber for Washington. And for their opponent, the Brandon Valley Lynx tonight, as they head out onto the court, their head coach, Mark Statham, a native of Del Rapids, bringing out a starting lineup that looks like this. Bryn Rist, the 5'6 junior, will bring up the basketball this evening for the Brandon Valley Lynx, but the big name is Heidi Hoff, the 5'11 senior, headed to USD next season to be a Coyote. Right now trying to finish up her high school career as a Brandon Valley Lynx, get her team back to the state championship for the second straight year. Lexi Hoover, the other guard, a 5'3 sophomore, Brianna Reugers, and Allison Kane, the 5'9 junior.
Kane had a big night last night with 19 points and 10 rebounds. Hoff had 13 points and 11 rebounds leading the way for the Brandon Valley Lady Lynx. Sioux Falls, Washington was led by Ellie Benson, who had 13 points and 7 rebounds. Emma Hansen, 9 points, 11 rebounds on the night. Sarah Zirpel with 6 points, but she is the tempo setter for the Sioux Falls Washington Warriors.
Yeah, she really does do a lot of great things on the floor, not only with the basketball, but defensively. And when she gets inside the lane with the ball, she can do some special things. So look for Zirpel to really set the tone for Washington tonight. And again, it's gonna be Heidi Hoff, the big USD recruit, heading to the Vermilion area next season. She's gonna be the big leader tonight for Brandon Valley. Those two are gonna probably not have a chance to really guard each other much. Very different styles of play for the two players, but they are both very dangerous and potent scorers here this evening for these two teams.
Brandon Valley did play Roosevelt during the season, or Washington, I should say. Washington beat Brandon Valley late in the year, 42-32.
We are just about set for action this evening inside Frost Arena. It's the final game on day two. It's semifinal Friday here in Brookings. When we return, we'll get you tip-off from Brookings. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more in a moment right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Every winning team needs a solid support system behind them. Whether it's one of the teams you're watching today or the station you're watching on, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. From high school sports to Red Green, the programs that you enjoy are made possible by the support and generosity of you, the viewer. If you're already a member of the fan club, Friends of SDPB, well, thank you. If not, joining is easy. Call 800-777-0789 now or log on to sdpb.org. Within a minute or two, you'll be back to the program and knowing you've done your part to support high school excellence here in South Dakota. Join us today at the $40 family membership level, and your pledge will go far to ensure that the extensive coverage of high school sports you love to watch on SDPB will continue. Catch the spirit. Join the Friends team today.
Welcome back inside Frost Arena. We are moments away from tip-off tonight between the Brandon Valley Lynx and the Washington Warriors. These two teams set for action here this evening. And let's check and see exactly how these two teams got to this point. Of course, we're gonna have to start with the districts. And for Washington, we'll start with them. They defeated Lincoln early on in the districts, 55-48, took on Brandon Valley and actually beat them in the District 2AA tournament, 51-50 to get to the state tournament, but split with the first round foe during the regular season. Rapid City Central had a big win in that one just to get into tonight's contest. And now, Washington took on O'Gorman earlier on, I should say, the big 44-39 win to get to the semifinals. And then it was Brandon Valley taking on Rapid City Stevens, and they had a big tournament as well just to get into the state tournament here, the AA rankings, of course, with their win 70-62, or correction, I should say 48-45 over Yankton, and then, of course, losing to Washington 51-50 in the District 2 AA. Then had to go take on Watertown, and that one was close again for Brandon Valley, and taking on the Watertown Arrows and beating them 56-54 in the Region 1 AA just to get here to the state tournament. It was a long road for Brandon Valley, but looking to get back to the championship yet again.
Yeah, for Brandon Valley, three playoff games, the combined margin of victory for the winning team, 6 points. They have been in three nail biters, and actually their win over Rapid City by Rapid City Stevens by 15 points, by far their most comfortable win of the postseason.
We are just about set for tip-off here tonight inside Frost Arena. The winner of number 2 Sioux Falls Washington versus number 3 Brandon Valley will take on number 1 Mitchell in the championship. Well, our job is done. Now let's send it over to the PA announcer here inside Frost Arena, Scotty Quaz, for tonight's starting lineups and the announcement of not only the cheerleaders, but the two teams as well. Scotty?
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to tonight's semifinal session of the 2012 State AA Girls High School Basketball Tournament. The South Dakota High School Activities Association reminds everyone that these state tournament games are intended for the enjoyment and benefit of high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the proper support of these student athletes. That's why the South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard support good sportsmanship. With good sportsmanship, everyone is a winner. Support good sportsmanship during tonight's game. And now let's meet the cheerleaders. First off, for Brandon Valley, Katie Benz, Victoria Heinrichs, Kate Johnson, Haley Carmody, Haley Thomas, and Alyssa Christensen. The cheer coach for the Lady Lynx, Katie Lane. And now the cheerleaders for Sioux Falls, Washington. Paris White, Jean Madsen, Rachel Semler, Kaya Clary, Ashton Parks, Jasmine Richard, Claire Bryant, and Brianna McHugh. The cheer coaches for the Sioux Falls Washington Warriors are Becky Parks and Brianna Means. And now let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's game in alternating order. For Brandon Valley, number 10, Bryn Rist. For Sioux Falls Washington, number 4, Sarah Zirpel. For Brandon Valley, number 12, Lexi Hoover. For Sioux Falls, Washington, number 10, Jessica Carson. For the Lady Lynx, number 34, Brianna Rogiers. For the Warriors, number 32, Hannah Weber. For Brandon Valley, number 42, Heidi Hoff. For Sioux Falls, Washington, number 34, Emma Hansen. And for Brandon Valley, number 44, Allison Kane. For Sioux Falls, Washington, number 44, Ellie Benson. The coaching staff for Brandon Valley are assistant coaches Mark Schleckaway, Jill Austin, Jeff Lochner, Wayne Allen. The head coach for Brandon Valley, Mark Statham. The assistant coaches for Sioux Falls, Washington are Brett Schleckaway, Larry Toft, Gretchen Johnson, Todd Alberty, Shariah Anderson, and the head coach, Nate Malchow. Our referee tonight, Don McEnroy, umpire Mike Pooley, and umpire Randy Stanton.
We are set for action. Tonight, it'll be the Washington Warriors in their home white uniforms. Black lettering and orange trim. Brandon Valley making their way out onto the floor right now in their black road uniforms, red lettering and white trim. It'll be Heidi Hoff set to jump against Washington's Emma Hansen. And the tip goes to the Warriors. And we're underway in the final game here today on day two of the Class AA Girls State Basketball Tournament. Zirple for three, no, off the iron to start the game. Washington gets the rebound, the put back off the glass, no. Brandon Valley with the ball. They're going to run Hoover from the left wing. Guarded by Zirple, spins away from Zirple. And now the Lynx will settle down and get into their half-court offense.
Washington going to a zone right away, 2-3 zone.
Hoover from the left wing, works it over to the left corner. Hoff asks for the ball, now 14 to shoot. She gets a screen from the free throw line. Back to Hoover in the right wing. Pass inside, blocked, but a foul called on the play. Hansen got her hand on it, but gets called for the foul. And that'll send Brandon Valley to the line here early tonight. Brianna, in our scoreless game.
Yeah, Brianna Rozier, a nice move along the baseline. She'll get a pair of free throws, the 5'10 senior.
First attempt is good, and it's Brandon Valley who strikes first tonight. First of two free throw attempts in for the Brandon Valley Lynx. Rozier, 2-for-2. 2-0, Brandon Valley here in the early goings. Warriors with the ball. Benson passes to Zirple in the right corner. She goes baseline, kicks it inside the lane. Jumper from the free throw line, in and out. Benson with the rebound, though, keeps it alive. And Emma Hansen's going to get called for the offensive foul. She tried to clear out and create some space there in the left corner. Swung the left arm and got called for the offensive foul. Her first personal. Second team foul on the Warriors.
Yep, you love to see aggressiveness going for the loose ball, but Weber just a little too aggressive there and picks up the second team foul on Washington.
2-0, Brandon Valley, they've got the ball. Hoff from the left wing, goes baseline, stops, 10-footer, no. Tipped away and a foul called. It'll be a pushing foul. Let's see who the officials call this one on. It'll be on Benson.
And credit Brandon Valley for getting in good rebounding position. Again, that's Rozier making a play.
Zirple with the steal. She'll push it in transition. One-on-one fast break. She goes in, right-handed layup off the glass. No, but the foul on Brandon Valley. It'll be on Bryn Rist, the 5'6 junior. Zirple, just a 5'7 senior, heading to the line now for Washington. Trying to get the Warriors on the board in this 2-0 game.
Wrist did not cut off the lane to the bucket and did not cut off that angle, and Zirple saw it and made her way there and drew the contact.
Second attempt for Zirple is good. We've got a 2-2 tie. Here comes Wrist and the Lynx. Wrist at the top of the key, hands it off to Hoff. Rogers travels in front of the Washington bench. She was double-teamed and looked a little uncomfortable over there on the left wing. Gives the ball back to Washington now in our 2-2 tie.
Carson out, Danae Veldkamp in for Washington.
Here come the Warriors. Benson with the ball. Washington working from right to left on your screen. Zirple at the top of the key.
Links in a man-to-man.
Veldkamp back to Zirple, I should say. Three, no good. Ball loose near the half-court line. And the Warriors will go over and back. Brandon Valley will get the ball back here now. It's 6:01 remaining here in the first quarter. 2-2 your score. Brandon Valley took the early lead. Washington tied it up with a pair of free throws, and here we stand in the 2-2 tie. Hoff from the right corner. Brings it up near the top of the key. Hoover now from the left wing. Passes back to Hoff to the left baseline. Long two is good from 18 feet away. Heidi Hoff gets that Brandon Valley student section into a frenzy. Boy, they cover a lot of seats here inside Frost Arena. The men's team for Brandon Valley not in the state tournament, so this is their big chance to dance here in the month of March. Zirple with the miss. Brandon Valley comes up with the defensive board. It was Rozier with the ball. Hoff brings it up court, shot off the glass, no. Washington with the rebound. Hansen came up with it. And here comes Benson now inside the lane. Her shot off the glass, no, not quite strong enough. Hoff She'll run it up court for the Lynx. Off to the right side of the paint, kicks it back out. Three on the way. Too soft. Rebounded by Washington.
A little wild pace here the last couple of possessions.
Ellie Benson with the left-handed dribble. Into the left wing to Veldkamp. Veldkamp kicks it back out. Benson with the ball near the free throw line. Back to Zirpel. She spins. Zirpel floats it in from 5 feet away. Nice move there from the senior. Ties this game back up at four apiece.
If it sounds loud, we have two raucous high school cheering sections directly behind our broadcast location.
Frost Arena about two-thirds full this evening for this semifinal matchup. Off inside the lane, floater from 5 feet away, off the left side of the iron. Rebounded by Hannah Weber for Washington. Zirpel, right wing, drives inside, gets a little push off, no foul, the shot, no, off the back of the iron. Hoff gets the rebound, pushing it again for the Lynx. She's inside the lane, floater from 3 feet away, no good. Rebound on the play, and look out. Heidi Hoff's arm got tangled up on the play. That's scary. Hoff appears to be okay, though, as that left arm got twisted around the Washington Warrior, Hannah Weber. Boy, lucky both players didn't get hurt on that play, but Heidi Hoff with a sigh of relief as she realized, oh, she could have been in some serious trouble the way her arm got twisted and mangled inside that mess.
Boy, that could have been very, very dangerous there as she was twisted around that arm behind her, but she appears to be okay. Misfired down low.
Turnover for Brandon Valley.
They're trying to find Val Peltier, who just checked into the game. She is open, but she made a move towards the bucket as the pass was coming in to where she was the moment before.
Warriors with the ball. 3:28 remaining here in the first quarter. 4-4 your score. Three on the way off the back of the iron. Offensive board for the Warriors, and the putback is good. She's just a freshman, but Carly Coiter cleaning up the glass there for Washington.
I think that was Michaela Mayer.
Michaela Mayer, you're right. Mayer, a sophomore. Ball tipped by the Warriors, kept alive by Mayer. And here comes Ellie Benson bringing it up after the save.
Benson made that play, and Mayer picked up the loose ball.
Warriors, 2:45 remaining. Benson from the left wing, drives inside. Her shot not quite strong enough off the left side of the iron. But two more free throws coming up for Sioux Falls, Washington. 6-4 your score right now. 2:41 remaining and a sub coming in for the Warriors. It'll be Kelsey Knacks, the 5'5 sophomore, here after the free throw. Benson has it rattle around, no good, in and out.
Bryn Risk picked up her second foul, so she'll go to the bench, and Hoover's going to come in to replace her.
Brianna Roizier is back in the game as well, the 5'10 senior. Benson's second attempt is good. One of two this time around. Washington with a three-point lead, 7-4, 2:41 remaining. Brandon Valley with the basketball.
Kelsey Connect into the game now, number 30 for Washington.
Hoover gets it over to the right wing. Brandon Valley trying to pass it around the perimeter. Too strong that time for Hoover. Out of bounds in front of the Washington bench. And the Warriors will get it back now with 2.5 minutes remaining. Here comes Washington. Connect. In the right wing. 3-point on the way is good. Kelsey Connect gives Washington their largest lead of the day, 10-4. Hoover trying to settle things down for Brandon Valley. Passes to Hoff. She spins in the right wing. Hoff backing back out. Ball to the top of the key, nearly tipped out of bounds. Kept alive there by Brandon Valley. Dykstra saved it. Hoff now long three from the right wing, tipped. Ball loose, picked up by the Warriors. Dangerous pass tipped by Hoover, recovered by Zirpel. She'll push it up court now with Hoover behind her. Now slowing up with 27 seconds on the shot clock. Zirpel lost the handle though, and it goes out of bounds.
Washington definitely with the momentum, and Kelsey Connect. I think that's her first bucket of the tournament. I don't know if she even played yesterday. I don't think
nope.
she did.
She did not.
And this is a very deep Washington team. Coach Maucho, he'll sub three, four players at a time throughout a basketball game.
10-4 your score, a minute 30 remaining here in the first half, or first quarter of action. Rozier's to the right wing. Hoover, now into the right corner, pass inside. Rozier's, her shot blocked. Warriors pushing it in transition now, here they come. Veldkamp finds the shooter in the left corner, 3-point no, rebounded by Brandon Valley. Kane will bring it up now for the Lynx. Kane with a three, good. 10-7, it's just a 3-point game after Kane's tray. And here come the Warriors again, three on the way. In and out, and a foul called on the play. That was Washington's Hannah Weber. Weber.
Well, she landed hard.
She took a couple hard shots in the first game against Sioux Falls O'Gorman yesterday. Falls face first to the floor there. She'll check out, get checked out by the trainer for a moment. She hit both of her elbows to the floor and might have gotten her chin on the floor as well. 3-point game here now for Brandon Valley. They trail, Hawk with the ball on the left wing. Hoover now centering it near the top of the key. Hoff in the right wing. Hoover again now to the left wing. Quick pass inside to Hoff. Left side of the paint, her shot off the glass, no. Here come the Warriors. Pushing it up forward is Neiman. She'll step back for three. No, off the right side of the iron. Mayer gets the rebound. Neiman resetting the offense now with 17 on the clock. The shot clock is turned off. So the Warriors trying for the last shot of the quarter. Now under 10 to play. Crossover for Benson at the top of the key. She kicks it inside. Pass to Mayer. Her shot off the glass is good. And that's how your first quarter comes to an end. Washington with a 12-7 lead after the first quarter of play. We'll take a timeout from Frost Arena. Washington with the early lead here in the semis. 12-7 your score. We'll be back with more in a moment on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
And don't forget, complete stats and information about all South Dakota High School Athletic Championships can be found online. Log on to sdpb.org for complete coverage.
Welcome back inside Frost Arena. Start of the second quarter. Three on the way from the left wing is good. Brandon Valley kicking off the third quarter in fine fashion. Allison Kane with the tray there. 12-10 your score now. Washington with the ball and a 2-point lead. Zirpel top of the key with 7:35 remaining until halftime. She loses the handle. Ball tipped loose into the backcourt. Rozier's tangled up with Zirpel and a jump ball called. Zirpel slams her hand to the floor in frustration as the possession arrow favors Washington. They get a big break there, but Zirpel showcasing a little frustration there after the near turnover.
Weber back into the game, replacing Sydney Cole for Washington.
Washington with the ball now, just eight to shoot on the shot clock. Zirpel from the right wing gets it inside. Hansen off the glass, no, but a foul on the play. And that'll send the Warriors back to the free throw line. Correction, that's Hannah Weber, I should say. Yeah, she goes to the charity stripe.
Yeah, Rozier's going to pick up her first foul for Brandon Valley. 2 of 10, the Lady Lynx were in the first period from the floor. Washington 4 of 15.
Weber's first free throw attempt is good. For Sioux Falls, Washington, they're 4 of 5 from the free throw line so far today. Second attempt, nothing but net for Hannah Weber.
5 turnovers in the first quarter for Brandon Valley, just 2 for Washington.
4-point lead for the Warriors. Brandon Valley with the ball. Lynx with a lob pass inside the lane. Hoff tries to keep it alive. It's off her hand and out of bounds. Hoff can't believe it. But the Warriors will get the ball back now with a 4-point lead.
Rebounding even, 10-9 after one period in favor of Washington.
Benson bringing up the ball for the Warriors. Carson into the right wing. Weber bounces it inside. It's tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Hoover for Brandon Valley. 6:48 remaining here till halftime, and the Warriors want a sub. They're going to get Weber out of the ball game. Taylor Gackle back in, the 5'9 senior. Ball in the right wing. 19 to shoot for Washington. And a jump ball called as Rozier got tangled up inside with the newcomer, Taylor Dackel.
That was a good hustle by Rozier, and the possession arrow favors the team in black.
Brandon Valley down by four. Brandon, the lower seed of the two in this game. Washington, the two seed. Brandon Valley, the three seed. A dangerous cross-court pass there, recovered by the Lynx. Hoff now top of the key. She works her way to the right elbow. Hoover back to the top. Ball tipped out of bounds. I get a souvenir here inside Cross Arena.
Nice hands.
I've sat here all year long for Jackrabbits games. I've gotten used to that outlet. Brandon Valley with the ball here now. Just 12 on the shot clock. 6:20 remaining in the game. Hoover back to the top of the key for the Lynx. Rozier with six to shoot. Hoff now from the baseline. Her floater tipped out of bounds with two to go. It'll be last touched by Brandon Valley. Washington will get the ball back here. 6:09 remaining and a four-point lead in Brookings.
Lady Lynx still going man-to-man. That's Neiman with the ball, picked up by Hoff.
Back to the top of the key now for the Warriors. They're looking inside for Mayer. Neiman again, left wing, sizing up Hoff. She crosses over to the right hand. Now to the top of the key, inside the paint, jump stop. Her shot off the back iron, no. Hoff with the defensive rebound and a foul called on Dackel.
That's her first. Should be team's fifth.
Five team fouls for the Warriors, three for Brandon Valley. Neither team in foul trouble in what has been a clean game for the most part here so far today. But a very intense first half of action here between the two and three seeds at the AA tournament. Warriors back on defense as Hoover gets the offense set up. She wants a three off the back of the iron. Dackel almost came up with the rebound. Pass inside to Hoover, back out to Hoff. She drives inside. It's stripped from her hand, but a foul, and it's going to be on Zirpel. Two free throws coming up as Zirpel picks up her first personal, sixth team foul on Washington.
Heidi Hoff only 2 points in this game so far, but she'll be at the line for a pair.
Hoff off the back of the iron. It goes to the right. No good. More subbing going on as Dackel and Zirpel check out for Washington. Into the game now for the Warriors. Sydney Cole, 6'1 sophomore. She'll be joined on the floor for the moment anyways by Emma Hansen. Hansen gets the inbound after the make for Hoff. One of two this time around. It's a 3-point game. Washington with the lead and the ball. Hansen near the right baseline. Passes up to the top of the key to Neiman. A dangerous pass there with 20 to shoot on the shot clock. She crosses over to the left hand. Now in the left wing, back to the top of the key to Neiman. Neiman, 12 to shoot. Benson, over to Hansen in the right corner. Her two on the way, no good. Recovered by the Warriors, a fresh 35. Neiman with the ball again, into the right corner. Hansen back to the top of the key, inside to Ellie Benson. She kicks it out, Neiman for three.
Good!
Neiman with a big tray there for the Warriors, and it extends their lead back to six. 17-11 your score. Lob pass inside the lane. Shot blocked, but a foul on Washington. And it'll send Brandon Valley back to the line. Two more free throws coming up for Val Peltier, the 5'9 junior.
Sydney Cole picks up her first personal foul for Washington. It was a nice pass by Kane inside to Peltier.
Peltier, 62% free throw shooter on the season. First free throw is good. Back to a 5-point lead now for the Warriors. Brandon Valley trying to get back in this ballgame.
Jordan Griffin, number 52, checking in for Brandon Valley.
Second attempt on the way for Peltier. Is good. 2 for 2 this time around. Boy, this one a nail biter in the first half. Just a 4-point lead again for Washington. 4:20 remaining here in the first half. Warriors with the ball. Neiman to the top of the key to Zirpel. Zirpel backing out, now bringing it back in. Neiman up to the top of the key. Pass into the right corner. Hansen spins, looks inside, cross-court pass. Neiman was open, drives inside instead, passes it away into the hands of Hoff. Hoff will push it in transition, up court to Hoover. Her left-handed layup is good. Here come the Lynx, down by just two, 17-15, your score. Neiman from the left corner. She centers it at the top of the key for Washington. Crossover at the free throw line. She goes in hard. Hansen fouled on the way. Emma Hansen going to the ground as she tried for the right-handed up and under, but now has two free throws coming her way as the Warriors try to extend their lead once more.
Jordan Griffith picks up the foul for Brandon Valley. Benson at the line for a pair.
Her first attempt in and out, no good. More subbing going on for both teams. Mayer back in the ballgame now for Washington. And Rozier checking back in for Brandon Valley. The Warriors are going to have another sub coming in a moment. It's Taylor Gackle, but she'll be subbing in for the shooter. Still one attempt on the way for the Warriors. Hansen at the line. Her second attempt off the back of the iron. Rozier had the ball. Mayer tipped it out of her hand. Ball loose on the floor. Picked up by the Lynx. Here comes Hoff. Hoff to the right side of the paint. Her floater off the glass. Too strong. Rebounded by Zirpel. Zirpel in transition from the far sideline. She's at the top of the key. Now inside the lane. Zirpel from 10 feet away. Off the glass. Meyer going to get called for the foul. It's an offensive foul called on the Warriors. And Brandon Valley will get the ball back. That's the eighth team foul now on Washington. So everybody's going to have to go down to the other end of the floor here for a 1-1. It'll be, I believe, Hoover going to the line here for the free throw.
And now Gackle in to replace Hansen. Michaela Mayer, 6-foot sophomore, picks up her first personal foul. 57% shooter is Hoover.
Free throw attempt is good. Second attempt. Nothing but net for Hoover, and we've got a tied ball game with 3:20 remaining. 17 all your score. Washington with the ball. Benson bounces it to Gackle. Now over to Neiman. Neiman from the left wing for three. In and out. Rebounded by the Lynx. Stolen back by the Warriors, but a foul called on the play. It'll be on Ellie Benson. Ninth team foul for the Warriors.
Give you a quick update from the A tournament. They're just underway. Second period of play. Parkston leads Miller 20-16.
It'll be still just a 1-1 for Brandon Valley. They've got a chance to take the lead for the first time since the early seconds of the ball game. Brandon Valley led 2-0. Otherwise, it's been all Washington here this evening. And they will. She makes the first on the 1-1. Second attempt on the way for Brandon Valley. Good. 2-for-2 for Allison Kane, the 5'9 junior. Here comes Benson and the Warriors. She goes all the way in for the right-handed layup. No. Mayer inside to clean things up. Back to Gackle. She goes for the right-handed layup. That's no good. Ball kept alive for Brandon Valley and tipped. They're going to say no. It's going to be a timeout for Brandon Valley before it goes out of bounds. The Lynx get the timeout. It'll be a 30-second break here with 2:49 remaining here in the second quarter. Right now, it's Brandon Valley with the 19-17 lead over Washington with 2:49 remaining.
South Dakota Public Broadcasting is able to provide coverage of the State High School Girls Basketball Championships and other quality programs you enjoy because of the generous support of viewers like you. We ask you to take a moment of your time to express your appreciation by logging on to sdpb.org and clicking on the support button and make a pledge right now. And we always thank you for your support of South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Both teams make their way back out on the floor. Hoover inbounding it for Hoff as Brandon Valley brings it up with the 2-point lead. Hoover now near the half court line. Ball in the left corner, three on the way, off the back of the iron, no, rebounded by Washington. Benson with a big defensive board there for Washington. They now have the even keel in rebounding, 15 rebounds apiece for both teams here in the first half. Zirpel, top of the key, 20 to shoot for Washington. 2:15 remaining till halftime. Mayer Top of the key now to the right wing to Benson. Zirpel sizing up Hoover, back to the top of the key to Hanson. Hanson, seven to shoot now. Kicks it inside to Mayer, and a foul called as Rozier tried for the steal. For Rozier's, that will be her second.
But only the team's fifth, I believe. As Connect will check out Neiman in for Washington.
Inbound from Mayer, going into the right corner to Hanson. Washington with the ball. Neiman into the corner now to Benson. Hanson from the left side of the paint. She's trying to get away from not one but two defenders. It's tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Lynx.
This has been an intense basketball game.
1:50 remaining in the first half. Hanson from the left wing centering it to Benson. Benson now to Zirpel from the free throw line. Her off balance shot no good. Mayer keeping it alive. Hanson comes down with the offensive board. She's fouled. The putback no good, but two coming up now for Hanson. And she goes to the line for Washington.
And I think Kane's going to get tagged for that foul. And so that's her first.
Emma Hanson has it go off the front of the iron, rolls halfway around the rim and falls through. Shooter's touch that time for Hanson. Mayer checks out of the ball game. 1 point lead right now for Brandon Valley. Check that, we've got a tie ball game.
That ends that 6-0 run that Brandon Valley was on.
Hoover with the ball, she sets up the offense for Brandon Valley. You hear the student section for Washington getting into the ball game now. Hoff into the right corner. Back to Hoff. Hoff for three. Good. Heidi Hoff brings the Brandon Valley crowd to its feet once more. Neiman for three. No, off the front side of the iron. Rebounded by Hoover. Hoover's pass up court to Hoff. Tipped on the play by Neiman. She goes to the ground. And Neiman will pick up her first personal for Washington.
Double bonus time.
Heidi Hoff now to the line.
Parkston has extended their lead over Miller, 27-16, with 5 minutes left to go in the second period. That's at the A.
First attempt for Heidi Hoff is good.
She's got 7 points in the contest.
Second, no good for Hoff. 23-19 your score. It's a 4-point lead for Brandon Valley. Under a minute to play. Benson to Zirpel in the left wing. She'll get a screen near the top of the key. Zirpel kicks it to the right baseline. Her shot is good. That's Gackle for two. Pumping her fist. She heads back down the floor, and it's just a 2-point ball game.
What a nifty pass by Sarah Zirpel. She just kind of shuttled that with her left hand to a wide open player, and now there's very little difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
Yeah, about a 2-second difference now. Hoff near the half court line. Neiman not really putting any pressure on Hoff, so she's content just holding the ball now, 10 to shoot. Hoff working her way in as she starts her dribble. Now the ball at the top of the key for the Lynx. Pass to Hoover, right wing three-point attempt. Off the front of the iron, Zirpel with the ball. Here's the shot at the half.
Off the
backboard. And that's how your first half comes to an end. 23-21, Brandon Valley, the three seed, with a 2-point lead over number 2, Washington. What an exciting first half of basketball here in Brookings. We're going to see if we can't get the Brandon Valley head coach over for a quick word here before we go to our halftime break. And he will join us now, Mark Statham, with my partner, Steve Toon.
Coach, that was a wild first half of basketball. You're down by 6 early, but then the furious run there in that second quarter. What turned it around for your team?
You know, I thought we did a really good job being physical inside. I thought we held up on the glass. They're a lot bigger than we are, and we just had to be physical on the glass, and we got some boards, and I thought we just kind of hung in there.
Is the pace of the game to your liking?
Yeah. I mean, if we let them come down and set up in that zone, they're really going to slow us down. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to attack that zone early before it gets set up.
All right, what's your team going to have to improve in the second half on offense and defense to prevail?
Oh, I think we just got to keep being solid on both ends. I would like to see us, you know, maybe find the shooter a little bit sooner if we get an open girl. But, you know, they're so athletic, they cover up things pretty well.
Coach, thanks for your time. Good luck.
Good, thanks.
Mark Statham, the head man for Brandon Valley. And it's been a fantastic semifinal so far. The Lynx on top of the Warriors, 23-21. We'll take a break, come back with more from halftime here at the Girls Class AA Basketball Tournament. It's on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Welcome back inside Frost Arena. It's halftime here in Brookings. And right now, Brandon Valley leads Washington 23-22. Steve, let's get some halftime stats.
You bet. For Brandon Valley, they are 5 of 18 from the floor for 28% and 3 of 8 from beyond the arc. That's good for 38%. 10 of 12 from the free throw line for the Lady Lynx. They have 16 rebounds. They have 6 turnovers. They are led in scoring by Allison Kane with 8 points. She also has 5 rebounds. Heidi Hoff with 7 points and 3 boards. 4 points for Lexi Hoover. 2 points apiece for Brianna Rozier and for Val Peltier off the bench. For the Washington Warriors, they are 6 of 25 from the floor. Not very good, 24%. They are 2 of 11 from beyond the arc. 7 of 10 at the free throw line. They have 18 rebounds, so they're winning the battle on the boards by a pair, and they've committed 4 turnovers. In the point total, a very balanced attack for Sioux Falls, Washington. 4 points for Michaela Mayer, Sarah Zirpel, 3 points apiece for Kelsey Connect, Hannah Neiman, 2 points each for Taylor Gackle, also for Emma Hansen, Hannah Weber, and Ellie Benson, who had the big night last night with 13, just has 1 point, just 1 free throw, 1 of 2 at the line tonight for Sioux Falls, Washington. Give you a quick update from the A tournament. They're about halfway through the second period, and it's Parkston leading Miller 35-24. St. Thomas Moore won earlier tonight. Still waiting to get an update on that other B game. That is on SDPB1 television.
We are about 4.5 minutes away. Both teams just now making their way back onto the floor, and we're going to get our second half started here in a minute. But first, we need to take another timeout. When we come back, it's the second half of the semis when we come back to Brookings after the break right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Activities Association Championship is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, by Dakota Bank, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
And welcome back to Frost Arena. Coach Malcho there. You got the lead early, but then Brandon Valley made a run. What turned that second quarter around in their favor?
As we should have. We just had a couple possessions, but they're a good team, and if you leave them open, they're going to hit shots. We got to be able to identify shooters a little better. To their credit, they knock them down, but our kids are hanging in there too. You know, it's not from a lack of effort. We're going to keep shooting, keep looking to hit some shots, but we told our kids in the locker room, regardless, you got to play to win, and you got to keep shooting, and I'm confident that these kids will do that.
Coach, best of luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Nate Malcho, the head man for the Washington Warriors. It's been an intense first half of basketball. Washington led for most, but it's Brandon Valley up here at the intermission, 23-21. We got an update from the B tournament. They're in the third quarter, just started. Sully Buttes ahead of Faith, 28-13.
Check out this quarter by quarter scoring total. Washington struck first in the fourth, in the first quarter. They outscored Brandon Valley 12-7, but it's the Lynx in the second period, 16-9 over Washington. And that allowed them to take the 2-point lead at intermission. And both teams back out on the floor, ready to go, and all the fans returning to their seats after the halftime break. It's a wild crowd here inside Frost Arena. You can see the student section for both teams over our heads here just a moment ago. Brandon Valley, the rainbow-colored crew, and the Warriors directly behind us. And it'll be Washington who gets the ball, working from left to right from your TV screens at home.
Lady Lynx going man-to-man.
Zirpel with the ball. She's going to launch a three off the right side of the iron. Hoff will push it up court. Quick drive inside the lane. Shot off the iron. No good for Brandon Valley. Here comes Washington again. Zirpel. She drives inside the lane. The up and under shot, no good. Benson had the rebound, goes to the ground again. Hoff now the ball up court to Hoover. Her left-handed layup, good, and the foul.
It was set up by the pass by Heidi Hoff and a nice finish by Lexi Hoover.
7:27 remaining here in the third quarter. We're just over 30 seconds into this third period. Hoover makes it a three-point possession for Brandon Valley. 26-21, 5-point lead for the Lynx.
Hoover now has 7 points in the game. That's two above her average.
Zirpel sets up the offense from the right wing. Benson passes it inside for the Warriors. Weber had the shot. She goes to the ground again, but a foul called on the play. I don't know if there's been a time here in this tournament today where Hannah Weber hasn't touched the ball and gone to the ground at least once. She's been getting beat up throughout this entire tournament. Staying tough in this game right now for Washington. Zirpel, quick pass inside. The shot and the foul. Big time play there. Zirpel found Emma Hansen. Hansen's putback is good. Now she goes to the line for a chance to make it a three-point play the old-fashioned way.
And within a couple of seconds, Brianna Rogiers just picked up 2 fouls. That is number 4. That's a huge loss for the Lady Lynx.
She's out for the entire third quarter, you would have to think, and at least the start of the fourth. As Hansen goes to the line, her free throw is good. 2-point ball game. Lynx lead by 2. Here comes Hoff and Brandon Valley. Ball at the top of the key right now for the Lynx. Kane back to Hoff. Now to the top of the key to Wrist. 3 on the way. No, off the front of the iron. Rebounded by Hansen. Washington with a chance to tie it. Benson to Zirpel for 3 for the lead. Good! 27-26. Washington with the 1-point lead. Hoover with the ball now for Brandon Valley. She's at the top of the key. Cross court pass to Hoff. She fakes the shot, drives inside, 15-footer, good. She floats that one in and gives the Lynx the lead back, 28-27. Weber, shot off the glass, no, but a foul called on the play. Weber fouled from behind. I believe it's gonna go on Bryn Wrist, or excuse me, correction, that'll be a Jessica Carson, I believe. No, it will.
Yeah, Bryn Wrist.
Bryn Wrist, excuse me, her third personal foul.
All of a sudden, fouls are racking up against the Lady Lynx.
Weber's free throw attempt off the right side of the iron, in and out.
Neiman replaces Veldkamp in the Washington lineup.
Weber back at the line. Her second attempt well short off the front of the iron, 0 for 2. Warriors remain down 1. Hoff. Her pass tipped by Zirpel out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Brandon Valley. It's off the right hand of Wrist. Big time play there for Zirpel. Washington with the ball and a chance to retake the lead. 6:03 remaining in the third quarter. Zirpel in the half court line. Now to the top of the key to Weber. Weber back to Zirpel, right wing. She crosses over, steps back for 3. Off the front of the iron, rebounded by Hoff. Hoff will push it in transition now near the free throw line, picks up her dribble. Hoover in the right wing. Back to Hoff at the top of the key. Bounce pass back to Hoff. Nobody to work with there, back to Wrist now. Ball in the right wing, 15 to shoot. Hoover over to Hoff. She brings it around now to the right baseline. And a traveling violation called on Brandon Valley. It was Peltier who got called with the stutter step.
Yep, she changed her mind and shuffled the feet. Had a thought, then had a better thought, but turned out to be a bad idea.
28-27 your score, 5:15 remaining here in the third quarter. Neiman from the left wing finds Zirpel near the right elbow, correction, left elbow. She backs it up. Benson now. Kicks it to the right corner. Hansen inside to Weber. She's to the right of the paint. Weber double team back to Hansen. Right corner for three. No. Rebounded by Hoff. Another defensive board for the Lynx. Brandon Valley with the ball. Hoff picks up her dribble in the backcourt. Now to Hoover. And here comes Brandon Valley in their half-court set. Hoff for three. No, off the front of the iron. Rebounded by Neiman. Here comes Ellie Benson going coast-to-coast. Left-handed layup. No. Ball tipped in the air. Zirpel's put back. No, they're going to wave that off. A foul called on the play. Weber got tangled up with Heidi Hoff. And a foul on the play. It'll be on Heidi Hoff, and she's still talking to the officials saying, hey, I was getting pulled around inside, but her talk with the officials is to no avail as she picks up now her first personal. Fourth team foul on Brandon Valley.
Well, those fouls are racking up for the Lady Lynx. That could be a key factor down the stretch.
Weber, Zirpel, and Hansen are out. Mayer is in for Washington. Gackle in as well. Neiman from the left wing. Crosses over, now picks up her dribble, hands it off to Benson. Benson setting up the offense with 4:25 remaining here in the third quarter. Benson bounce passes it from the free throw line and a foul called on Hoff. Quickly her second and the fifth team foul now on Brandon Valley.
This is not a good trend for Brandon Valley as wrist will check out and Jordan Griffith checking in, number 52.
Hoff looking a bit frustrated on the floor right now for Brandon Valley. As Neiman inbounds it from the left baseline. A fresh 35 on the clock for the Warriors. Neiman's going to have to get it in. Coach Melchow wants to talk things over. He takes a 30-second timeout with 4:18 remaining in the third. It's a 28-27 Brandon Valley lead here in the semifinals.
Update from the A tournament. Parkston up by 10 in the late in the second period of that game. 38-28. And at the B, they're in the third, still Big Sully Butte's lead. Hey, don't forget, you can purchase a DVD copy of any of the high school girls' championship games by calling 1-800-456-0766. DVD copies are $19.95 plus $5 for shipping and handling. Now, if you're a member of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, the shipping is free. Call 1-800-456-0766 or log on to sdpb.org and click on the shopping cart for your copy of any of the state girls' high school championship games.
Neiman will inbound it now from the left baseline again for the Warriors. She gets it to Meyer in the left corner. Washington will start off the offensive set here now with a fresh 35 on the clock. Neiman in the left corner guarded by Hoff. Neiman back to the top of the key to Zirpel. Zirpel with the left-handed dribble bounces it inside to Meyer. She loses the handle though and the Lynx pick it up. After the turnover, 28-27, Brandon Valley with the one-point lead. They're looking to extend it now as Hoff gets it near the half-court line. Now to the top of the key. Lynx again, slowing things down offensively. Kane, baseline, drives and steps out of bounds as she tries to keep it alive. Another turnover. Washington gets the ball back as Meyer checks out. Gackles out. Also checking out is Veldkamp. Back in the game is Hansen, Benson, and Weber. Zirpel and Neiman remain on the floor for Washington. Warriors with the ball. Benson, top of the key, over to Zirpel in the right wing. Back to the top of the key, now to Weber. She lobs it inside to Hansen, tipped away into the hands of Hoover. Hoover pushing it in transition. She centers it at the top of the key. Quick pass to the right wing. Kane's pass inside, nearly tipped away. Kane with the ball now steps inside. Long two, no, off the left side of the iron, and a foul called on Brandon Valley. It's an offensive foul on Jordan Griffith, the 5'9 junior. And we're going to move down to the other end of the floor here as Washington gets the ball back after the offensive foul called on Brandon Valley.
From the B tournament, Sully Butte's leading Faith 39-24 late in the third period of that semifinal game.
Benson passes to Neiman in the left wing. Neiman in front of her own bench now centers it at the top of the key back to Zirpel. Benson in the right corner finds Hansen inside all alone. She pumps her fist. Big time bucket for the Warriors as they retake the lead 29-28 here inside Frost Arena.
Missed assignment, and Hansen was wide open. Nobody even looking at her.
Griffith with a quick pass inside to Kane, and a foul called on Washington. It'll be on Neiman. For Neiman, that's her second personal. Second team foul on the Warriors here in the third quarter. Neiman checks out. Back into the ballgame is Danae Veldkamp, the 5'7 junior. Here's Brandon Valley again. Ball at the top of the key. Hoff dribbles to the free throw line. Now a little baby hook off the glass. No. Rebounded by Hansen. Zirkle from the far sideline. She's in the right wing. Now steps in. Back out. Benson setting up the offense for Washington. It's a one-point Warrior lead. Weber over to the left corner. Benson back to the top of the key to Hansen. Now back to Benson. Hansen posting up. Weber with the ball now to Zirkle as she backs off near the half-court line. 10 to shoot with 2:05 remaining here in the quarter. Zirkle drives inside, loses her dribble. Hoover got tangled up with Zirkle. It's a jump ball. Possession arrow favoring Brandon Valley.
That was some great defense on the drive by Zirkle. Hats off to Brandon Valley as they held their ground on that possession.
Minute 55 remaining in the third quarter. 29-28, Warriors lead. Hoover in the right wing for Brandon Valley. She'll bring it up to the top of the key. Now back to Hoff. 20 to shoot for the Lynx. Pass inside. Kane draws the blocking foul. Weber goes to the ground. That'll be her third personal foul. Third team foul on Washington, and Kane to the line for two.
Kane with a nifty move in the paint. She's got 10 points now.
Neiman back in the ballgame as Zirkle checks out with a minute 40 remaining for Washington. Third quarter coming close to an end here now as Kane gets to the stripe. Her free throw is good. 31-29 your score. Lynx lead by two. Quick two for Washington off the back of the iron. Ball picked up by Kane. A foul on the play. I believe it's going to be on Weber for Washington, and it is. That's her fourth.
Big foul there against Washington as Mayer's going to check into the game. Number 54. Update from the A tournament just underway. Third period of play. Parkston leads Miller 42-35.
It's a two-point game here in Brookings. Hoff with the ball, top of the key. Kane, right wing, back to Hoff for three. Good.
In the earlier game, we talked about you can't leave Carrie Young open. Same thing here for Brandon Valley. You have to account for Heidi Hoff at all times in the game.
Neiman in the right wing, getting some separation from the defense. She'll lob it inside to Mayer, but the pass was tipped into Hoover. Hoover pushing it for Brandon Valley now. 34-29. Hoff for three. Off the iron. Put back. Off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Washington. Big time rebound for Veldkamp. She kicks it up court to Benson. From the left baseline. Benson out. Veldkamp drives inside the lane. Her shot off the glass. No, but a foul on Brandon Valley. Foul on the play called on Val Peltier. The 5'9 junior picking up on the play, foul number one on the day. That's the seventh team foul, though, for Brandon Valley. So Washington to the line. It's a two-for-two shot here now for the Warriors, but it will be 1-1 remaining in the fourth quarter now for Washington as we get into the bonus already here in the third frame. Neiman out. Hansen out as well for Washington.
Zirkle back into the game.
Veldkamp makes her second, one of two this time around. Hoff will bring it up for Brandon Valley. It's a four-point lead for the Lynx. Under 40 to play here in the third. Brandon Valley slowing things up offensively. Hoover from the free throw line kicks it out. Three on the way from the left wing. No, off the back of the iron. Hoff with the offensive board. She'll reset. And now Brandon Valley can set up for the final shot with 20 to go.
Hoff thought about it but saw the shot clock and said, it was such a smart play by Heidi Hoff. Let's play for the final one. And now it's going to get loud in here. The fans to their feet.
Griffith has the ball tipped out of her hands. Saved by Gackle into the hands of Mayer. She passes it up court. Benson driving at the buzzer. No. And that's how the third quarter comes to an end. 34-30, Brandon Valley with the four-point lead. We've got the fourth quarter coming up in the semifinals after the break. We'll be back with more from Brookings in a moment here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Back to Frost Arena in the Class AA basketball tournament. Update from the A, 46-42, Parkston on top, about halfway through the third. And at the B, it's Sully Buttes ahead of Faith, 41-26. They're just underway in the fourth. Here, we've got a close one. And that's Hansen with the turnaround. She's got nine.
It's a two-point game here in Frost. Hoff with the ball in the Brandon Valley lead, 34-32. Hoff from the right wing up to the top of the three for Kane. No. Rebounded by Zirpel. Zirpel passes inside the lane, the bucket and the foul. Hansen gives a high five to Zirpel after the assist, and she's got a chance to make it a three-point play.
And that foul goes on Peltier, her second, and what a pass by Sarah Zirpel.
Free throw attempt is good. Warriors take the one-point lead. Griffith back in the ballgame for Brandon Valley.
Peltier checks out, and now the press going to be applied by the Warriors. Kane to trigger.
Inbound going to Hoff with full court pressure. She's at half-court line, driving inside. Shot off the glass. Good, and the foul. A blocking foul called on Weber. That's her fifth.
Wow, that is huge as Hannah Weber, the 5'9 senior, has just fouled out of the game. Gackle quickly to the scorer's table. This has been a back and forth affair, exactly what you would expect on a semifinal Friday night at the girls AA basketball tournament.
Hoff at the free throw line for Brandon Valley. It's good. She converts on the three-point play. Brandon Valley up by two. We've got 7 minutes and change remaining here in the fourth quarter. It's been a dandy today between the 2 and 3 seed. The winner takes on the number one seeded Mitchell Colonels tomorrow for all the marbles here in the AA rankings. Zirpel from the free throw line. Her floater is good. It's a tie ball game, 37 all. Hoover pushing it now for Brandon Valley. Bounce pass to Griffith, tipped and stolen away by Zirpel. It's a 3-on-2 break. Zirpel in the lane, her shot off the glass, in and out. Rebounded by Brandon Valley. Pass up court, tipped by the Warriors. Benson keeps it alive. Hansen now recovers it. Zirpel in the right wing. She's guarded by Hoff. Cross court pass, Gackle for two, off the iron. Rebounded by Benson, tipped free, rebounded by Kane, and now a foul called from behind. It'll be on Gackle.
Wow, a mad scramble there. Up and down the court we go.
Wow. 37 all here in Brookings. 6:29 remaining. Brandon Valley inbounding it in front of the Washington bench. Full court pressure coming from the Warriors.
16 fouls against Washington.
Hoover in the backcourt. Hansen in front of her. Kane gets it at the half-court line. All alone is Griffiths for the left-handed layup.
Somebody forgot about her.
Zirpel will bring it up now. Brandon Valley back to a two-point lead. Zirpel right wing drives inside, kicks it out. Benson crosses over at the free throw line. Zirpel for three. Good! A big three for Washington. 40-39 your score.
Back and forth we go, and here's Hoff.
Her shot off the glass, no. Hansen gets the rebound. Here come the Warriors again. Zirpel right wing. Head fake in the ball carry. Yep, she got called for the carrying violation. Tried to go street ball there for a moment. Got called for the carry and a timeout call. Brandon Valley wants to talk things over. It's a full timeout here with 5:48 remaining. Washington leads 40-39 here in the fourth quarter.
And don't forget, South Dakota Public Broadcasting, it's statewide with three TV channels. SDPB1 is our primary channel, broadcasting in high def and presenting our regular mix of children's programming, science, nature, drama, history, and the arts. SDPB2 brings you world and features documentary, history programming, and live news coverage from peer and public affairs. And SDPB 3 is for the cook, the artist, and the explorer in all of us. All channels are available for free over the air and on most cable companies across South Dakota. Join SDPB as we triple your access to the world. And more information about our channels online, including our lineup and schedule at sdpb.org. It's also the place to go for stats, scores, and information about all South Dakota High School Athletic Championships. Log on to sdpb.org. 46-42, Parkston leads Miller halfway through the third period at the A. And at the B, it is Sully Buttes out in front by a comfortable margin. That's in the fourth quarter.
5:48 remaining here in the fourth quarter. It's been a nail biter today. The Warriors with the 1-point lead. Brandon Valley, though, has the ball after the timeout. Hoff spins around the half court line as she brings it up into the half court set. Kane for three, good! A big three for Brandon Valley. They retake the 2-point lead. 42-40 your score, 5.5 remaining. Washington with the ball, down by two. Zirpel drives inside, her floater in and out. Rebounded by Washington, Gackle will reset. She drives inside, bounce pass in the lane. Hansen's shot blocked, she's called though for the travel. Washington with the big mistake offensively, and Brandon Valley gets the ball back now with 5:15 remaining.
Brianna Rozier back in the game for Brandon Valley. She had to be very careful on that last defensive stand with the four fouls for Brandon Valley.
Hoover passes it into the right wing. Top of the key for Hoff. No, off the iron. Foul called. It's an offensive foul called on Rozier. For her, that's her fifth. So each team has one foul out of the game here now this evening. And we've still got 5 minutes plus in Brookings.
A huge, huge loss for Brandon Valley as Val Pelletier quickly to the scorer's table. And she'll have to replace Brianna Rozier in the lineup. Frustrating night for that young lady. She's going to finish the night with just 2 points. Mayer into the game to replace Gackle for Washington.
Benson to the line for Washington. It's a 1-1.
She only has 1 point on the night. She's 1 of 2 at the charity stripe.
Her free throw attempt is good. She'll be granted a second and a chance to tie the game. Now with 5:02 remaining.
I think the biggest lead for a long time has been, 6 points? And it hasn't been that in a long time.
Second attempt off the iron. Meyer with the rebound. Benson for the lead. Yes! Washington leads by one, 43-42. Hoff with the ball.
Washington back in a zone now.
Kane from the free throw line has it stolen away by Zirpel. She'll go coast to coast. The up and under is good. The foul on the play is called on Hoover. Zirpel to the line to try to make it a 3-point play.
Sarah Zirpel has taken over this quarter for the Washington Warriors. 7 points. She's got 14 in the game.
And she knew she made the free throw from the get-go. As soon as she released it, she was backing off. Zirpel with a little swagger in her step there after the make. It's a 4-point lead for Washington. 46-42 your score. Hoff, right wing. She's near the top of the key now, passes to the right baseline to Hoover. Back to Hoff, top of the key. Hoover for three, too strong, misses everything. Here come the Warriors. Zirpel slowing things up. Quick pass to Benson, nearly loses it. Hoover tried to get a steal. Hands it off to Neiman. Zirpel in the right wing. She thought about the three there for a moment. We'll bring it out again now with 13 to shoot. Under 4 to go in the ball game. Zirpel near the half court line. She'll get a screen from Hansen at the top of the key. Now from the right elbow for two. Good.
She's feeling it, my friend.
48-42 your score. Here come the Lynx again. Hoff in a hurry now from the right wing and a timeout called by Brandon Valley. Fourth 48-42 your score. The crowd erupts after the timeout. The largest lead of the day for Washington. It's a 6-point lead.
I think the fans were chanting, Zerpel, and why not? She has 10 points in this quarter alone, and Washington is up by 6 points. Hey, if you love boys high school basketball, we got a great documentary coming your way on March 18th. It's called Kings of the Court. We're celebrating 100th birthday of the boys high school basketball tournament. You're going to see some great memories from the past. March 18th, 8 p.m. Central, 7 p.m. Mountain. Make sure you watch that documentary on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
I'm J.J. Hardigan. He's Steve Toom. We've got an exciting finish here today in the semifinals. It's the AA Girls Basketball Tournament from Brookings. Brandon Valley down by six. They've got the ball. Hoff spins at the free throw line. It's tipped out of her hand, recovered by Zerpel. Zerpel's now going to slow it up and walk it up for the Washington Warriors. They've got time on their side here with the 6-point lead. It's a two possession game. Washington would like to extend it even further now as Coach Melchow sets up the play from the near sideline. Zerpel now, 3 minutes remaining, 10 to shoot on the shot clock. She gets a screen. Zerpel kicks it out, Neiman for three, no, off the right side of the iron. Brandon Valley with the ball. Pass up court, taken away by Neiman. Here comes Benson again for the Warriors. Benson slowing things up now. She's at the top of the key. And a foul called on the play. It'll be on, I believe, Hoover. Actually,
oh, no, they got a timeout.
Before the foul was committed, Coach Melchow called the timeout for Sioux Falls, Washington. No foul on the play. 2:36 remaining. It's a 6-point lead for the Warriors. 48-42 your score here in Brookings.
Update from the B tournament late in the fourth quarter. Sully Butte's comfortably in front of Faith, 51-26. At the A, late in the third period, Parkston 54, Miller 48. That's on SDPB 3 television. What a game this has been. This has been exactly the game we thought we would have.
This is what state tournament basketball is all about in the state of South Dakota. One of the most exciting games of the year at the AA rankings. And it comes in the semifinals of the AA state tournament. No matter what the outcome is, this one's going to go down as one of the greats in AA semifinal history. Right now, Washington with the 6-point lead. And a quick foul after the inbound. Benson went into the stands. One of the fans over there on the far sideline helps her to her feet. And now the young lady to the line for two. That's the 10th team foul on Brandon Valley. So the double bonus for the rest of the way here for the Warriors.
Second foul on Lexi Hoover for Brandon Valley.
Free throw is good.
And Washington, if they're going to win this contest, they're going to have to seal the deal at the charity stripe.
Second attempt coming up for Benson. Off the back of the iron. Hoff with the defensive board. A look of determination on the face of Heidi Hoff from the top of the key for three. Oh, well short. Rebounded, though, by Brandon Valley. Hoover for two from the left baseline. It's a 5-point lead now for the Warriors. 49-44 your score. Zerpel patiently bringing it up from the far sideline. She'll bring it up court, passes it inside the lane. Layup is good. Veldkamp lays it in. And the Warriors lead now 51-44 here in Brookings. Under two to play. Ball in the right wing. Kane for three, no. Rebounded by Hansen. Here come the Warriors again. Benson with Hoff right behind her. Kicks it out to Zerpel. She wants a three. Good!
Oh!
Zerpel with the fist pump as she makes her way back down court. It's a 10-point lead for the Warriors. Hoff, her right-handed layup, no, off the backboard, and a foul on the play.
Wow. This is one of the best fourth quarter performances I have ever seen, boys or girls basketball. And that is a foul on Allison Kane, her second.
It's a near capacity crowd here in the semifinals in Frost Arena. This student section behind us for Washington has been wild all day. They've gone nuts though here in the fourth quarter. And as the lead grows, they get a little louder. 56-44, Washington with the 12 point lead. Hoff from the left wing, throwing the elbows, and it's an offensive foul called as Zirpel goes to the floor. Heidi Hoff can't believe it. Frustration got the better of Heidi Hoff that time. She lost her composure for just a moment. And now Washington gets the ball back with a minute 26 remaining.
I'll tell you, it's not over yet as Hoff almost had a steal. Let's see who's going to get called for the foul. It is going to be Hoff. That's her fourth.
Hoff trying just a bit too hard here right now to do everything on the floor for Brandon Valley. Two quick fouls, and that sends Washington back to the line. Veldkamp for the free throws. It'll be two coming up for Veldkamp. She makes the first.
She has 4 points in the game.
Taking a look at some numbers on the season for Veldkamp as she gets back to the line. A 65% free throw shooter on the year. She makes them both. 14-point lead now for Washington. Hoff from the right wing, off the glass. The banks are open late in Brookings. She makes the big three there, a minute 11 remaining. It's a 58-47, 11-point lead for Washington.
See if Washington can play a little keep away here.
Hansen from the left corner. She's gonna drive inside, kicks it to Mayer. Her right-handed layup is good. Beautiful pass from Hansen. And the exclamation point for Washington. Under a minute to go. Hoff, the long three is good.
That's almost a four-pointer.
10-point game here now. And a quick foul called in the backcourt. Two more free throws coming up for Sarah Zirpel.
What a fourth quarter flurry by the Washington Warriors. This was a 34-30 game after three in favor of Brandon Valley, but if my math correct, has Washington scored 30 points in this quarter?
Yes.
Wow. Talk about finish up strong.
They had 30 points in the first three quarters combined and now have 30 points in the fourth quarter today. Washington, a furious race to the finish. Zirpel makes them. Makes one of two, I should say. 61-50 your score. Hoff kicks it over to Hoover. She nearly loses it. Back to Hoff in the right corner. She'll launch the desperation three. Not quite strong enough. Hansen with the board. Now under 30 to play. Washington will advance to the semifinals to take on the top-seeded Mitchell Colonels. It'll be one versus two tomorrow night for all the marbles. 61-50 your final score. It's a 30-point fourth quarter win for the Washington Warriors. They win by 11 here in the semifinals. Brandon Valley will take on Sioux Falls Roosevelt tomorrow night in the third place game. But celebration time for the Warriors as they get back to the championship for the third time in 5 years.
What a flurry, 31 points for Washington in that fourth quarter compared to 16 for Brandon Valley. You know, if you would have told me going into that fourth quarter that Brandon Valley scored 16 points, that they would lose by, what, 11? I would have called you crazy. But I tell you what, that was just a clutch performance by Sarah Zirpel.
A classy moment here by the coaching staff for Sioux Falls, Washington, taking a moment to talk to each and every player, especially Heidi Hoff and the coaching staff for Brandon Valley, congratulating them on a tremendous season and a valiant effort here today. The true class acts that they are in Sioux Falls, Washington, advancing to the championship for the third time in 5 seasons.
Nate Malcho joins us here at our broadcast location. Coach, congratulations. You're down by four going into the third quarter. What did you tell your team?
Well, play to win. And when you play to win, there's some risk taking. But if you want to get something done at some point, you got to take some risks. You know, Sarah Zirpel struggled a little bit, but she never doubted herself. I mean, it was a flurry right there, guys. I don't think I've ever been involved in something like that, and it snowballed, and the run happened. Give Brandon credit for running their stuff, for playing us tough. Boy, they support their team. I mean, they're all out, and it's a frenzy down here, guys. I don't think the people on TV understand that unless they got some high-quality surround sound, but it's unbelievable. Proud of our kids. No one expected these kids to do anything at the beginning of the year. We're playing a lot of young kids around in that. I'm so proud of them, and you know what? We're going to give her heck tomorrow night.
Now, Sarah had the big night, but some of your bench players came up big in that fourth quarter. Emma Hansen had been quite one of your starters, but she had a good, and Danae Veldkamp, got to give a shout-out to her. She was clutch in that fourth quarter.
Absolutely. A lot of contributions from a lot of kids, but we tell these kids, you know what? The star of the team is the team, and we don't have the marquee names maybe on this team that we have had in the past, but the star of the team is the team, and we got to keep this thing going tomorrow. It's going to be a great game against a good Mitchell club. They got us early. But you never know when you get to this point.
Do you think you can get 30 points a quarter? It seems like Mitchell does that in the first quarter. You did it in the final quarter. Do you expect a real up-tempo game tomorrow against the Colonels?
I think you got two teams that love to get up and down and play hard, and a lot of good players on that floor and a lot of good young players that will be playing on that floor. Before I get done here, hats off to Brandon. They played a great game. They played with a lot of heart. Coach Statham always has his guys or his girls ready to go. And what can you say about Heidi Hoff, guys?
Mm-hmm.
What a career.
What
a career. She's one of the best. I've been doing this for 11 years. I've been fortunate to be a part of a lot of good teams, but she's one of the best that I've ever gone against, and a competitor, and she's certainly proven that throughout her career. So hats off to Heidi on a great career.
And we noticed that you took a few extra moments to talk to her here, and I think that, we mentioned that on the air. It was a very classy display, Coach, for you and your staff to take a moment to acknowledge the great player there. And I know there's competitive juices there, but I know that you appreciate her game very much.
Look at Brandon Valley, and they come out of our district, guys. There's a lot of pride in District 2 right there, and we've clashed with these guys so many times through the years. And there's a deep mutual respect between the two programs right there with the players and the coaches. So hats off to them on a great year. But I'm going to tell you this, it's a great day to be a Warrior. And we're proud just to be from Washington High School and to be representing the school. A lot of good things going on. We're a small part of it, but we feel very happy to be a part of it.
Coach, thank you for your time tonight. Good luck tomorrow night in the championship game.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Nate Malcho, the head man for Sioux Falls, Washington. His team finishes up strong with a huge fourth quarter, and they win tonight. We'll take a timeout, come back, put a wrap on this game, and kind of preview tomorrow night in just a moment. This is the Class AA Girls Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Welcome back inside Frost Arena. What a wild finish to day two here at the South Dakota AA State Basketball Tournament. I'm JJ Hardigan, he's Steve Toom. We hope you've enjoyed day two and the first 2 days of our tournament in whole. And we had a final here tonight to Sioux Falls, Washington, the number two seed over Brandon Valley, the three seed, 61-50. The final here this evening, Steve Toom. No other words can describe it except for amazing the way this game came to a finish.
Yeah, this game was 34-30 Brandon Valley after three periods. But then Washington just kicked it into overdrive. Sarah Zirpel, 14 points alone in that fourth period of play. She almost outscored Brandon Valley all by herself. One of the great fourth quarters I've ever been witness to in all my years of broadcasting games here in South Dakota. And that was clutch, my friend.
Boy, it was a tight game really from halftime on. These two teams exchanging lead after lead, but you could just kind of feel there in the final 4 minutes, Washington slowly starting to build that momentum, and before you knew it, they had that big 10-point lead. It grew to 14. They got it back within 10 at one point for Brandon Valley on Heidi Hoff's back-to-back threes, but just not quite enough. And again, Coach Malchow highlighting it a minute ago when Steve had a chance to talk to him. An amazing career for Heidi Hoff. She's going to USD next season to play for the Coyotes at the D1 level, but boy, if you get recognition from Coach Malchow saying that you might be the best player he's ever seen, you better believe you're probably something special. And Heidi Hoff might have something to hang her head about tonight, but she's had an amazing career for Brandon Valley over the 4 years.
Yeah, let's check out the final stats here for Sioux Falls, Washington. From the game, 19 of 50 from the floor compared to 15 of 44 for Brandon Valley. From the free throw line, Sioux Falls Washington was 18 of 27, and Brandon Valley was a very good 13 of 15 from three-point land. Brandon Valley was 7 of 21 and even 33%, 5 of 18 for Sioux Falls Washington. The rebounding battle won by Washington 36 to 29, and as far as the turnovers go, 16 for Brandon Valley and 10 for Sioux Falls Washington. Individually, Sarah Zirpel with 21 points tonight. Emma Hansen had a huge game, a double-double, 14 points, 12 rebounds on the night. Those are the only two players in double figures, but a whole bunch of players contributing for Washington. Michaela Mayer with 6 points off the bench, 5 points for Danae Veldkamp. Ellie Benson, kind of a tough night for her, but she had some big plays on the floor, some good ball handling, and some couple free throws down the stretch, 5 points on the night for Ellie Benson. For the Brandon Valley Lady Lynx, Heidi Hoff, 21 points on the night, 8 rebounds as well. And Allison Kane, another strong night, a double-double herself, 14 points, 10 rebounds. Lexi Hoover chipped in with 9 points and 3 rebounds on the night, but just not enough. A great fourth quarter by the Washington Warriors, and they're on to the championship game against Mitchell tomorrow night.
Let's take a look at the bracket here quickly and update you on how tomorrow will look. We'll start off the day with the 7th and 8th place game. It'll be the two Rapid City schools, Rapid City Central taking on Rapid City Stevens, starting at noon Central, of course, with the daylight savings coming up tonight. Be sure to set your clocks appropriately, of course, for that. And then Aberdeen Central will be taking on Sioux Falls O'Gorman in the Constellation Championship starting at 1:45 Central time before our afternoon session gets underway. And it will be in the 3rd place game, Sioux Falls Roosevelt taking on Brandon Valley before the championship game tomorrow night. It'll be number 1 Mitchell taking on number 2 Sioux Falls Washington here in Brookings. We're in for another wild day of basketball tomorrow. JJ Hardigan and Steve Toom will have the coverage here from Brookings as we get set for championship Saturday here at the AA rankings. I tell you what, we're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we'll get you our final thoughts and send you on your way. But for now, we need to take a quick break. The postgame show will continue in a moment here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Activities Association Championship is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, by Dakota Bank, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
Welcome back inside Frost Arena. Before we send you on your way tonight, let's take a look around the rest of the great state of South Dakota and update you on what's going on in the A and B tournaments here this weekend.
Well, in the Class B tournament, it's going to be Summit versus Sully Buttes in the championship game. Both teams won pretty handily tonight. Summit over Sanborn Central Woonsocket at 48-32, and Sully Buttes just defeated Faith 54-30. So Summit back in the championship game once again. St. Thomas More a winner tonight in Class A in their semifinal over Elkton Lake Benton. Close game there, 47-41. And they're still underway out in Spearfish. That's on SDPB3 television and a minute and a half to go. It's Parkston ahead of Miller, 67-63 at the moment. And again, if you want to catch some more basketball, SDPB3 is the place to be for that one.
Final attendance today here in Frost Arena, 2,444 for the final session. Pretty outstanding crowd here today between Brandon Valley and Washington. But again, it's the Warriors who get back to the state championship for the third time in 5 years. They'll take on the top-seeded Mitchell Colonels with just one loss on the season tomorrow night for all the marbles here in the Class AA rankings. For now, it's JJ Hardigan and Steve Toom saying so long. We'll see you tomorrow afternoon here in Brookings as we get you the final day of the AA State Girls Basketball Tournament. Until then, we say so long and have a great night, everybody. You've been watching State High School Basketball right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.